What's good, y'all? It's Jessie, and I know it's been a long time. I literally said at the end of the last chapter that I would get to it fast because I wanted to know what happened with Steph, and I'm sorry, I've been MIA. And low-key, a lot of it was because I got a new piercing and putting a headphone on it was not going to be comfortable, and now it's fine. So, you know, terrible. And my microphone also croaked out on me, so I need a new microphone. Currently, I'm using the one off my webcam, which is fine, but, yeah. Anyway, hey, what's up, Alex girl? Okay, so we were gonna find Steph. And I think I did everything down here because I had to dance with, Ducky, right? I don't even know where he went. Okay. Anyway, so we are gonna continue. Go upstairs. Oh, yes. Yes. Go upstairs. I'm so bad. Don't mind the cats as they scratch in their litter box and play with the Coke bottle. Anyway, oh, okay, girl. Oh, it's Steph's upstairs. Okay. Oh, look how happy she is.
You said you have some news?
I'm leaving. I'm actually leaving Haven Springs. Can you believe it? Back on the road again. Fucking finally.
No!
Wait, seriously?
I'm gonna play music again, Alex. Anywhere I want.
My heart is just as broken.
I forgot how fucking good it feels.
Oh. I'll be happy.
Holy shit, Steph, that's so cool. I'm really happy for you. You better keep in touch.
You think it's that easy to get rid of me? Come on, Chen.
Oh, man. I'm so disappointed.
I need a new destination. You're my good luck charm.
Don't tell me you want to bring me with.
Good luck charms. Shut up.
Oh, I have to pick one?
Pick one.
Of course. Is this, Ellen, wish you were here. Salem. In the middle of the ocean. I like Salem, to be honest.
Salem, Halloween capital of the world, or so they say. Who do I hang out with?
Mass, oh no, witches, definitely.
You join a coven.
A lesbian coven.
Is there any other kind?
Yes!
You go to graveyards and perform rituals to speak to the dead.
None of which
I'm here for this work, witchy business.
But that's okay, because I get a load of old tombstone rubbings to decorate my apartment with.
Oh, God. Okay.
That sounds like a pretty spectacular plan.
Great. Then come with me.
I knew she was gonna ask that! Fuck.
To Salem?
Sure, why not? Doesn't have to be our first stop, but one day. I still have friends in Seattle.
Oh, my
shows.
God, Kat, you took a huge dump. My God.
I don't know. Kansas City, Vegas, wherever we want.
Cons about having a cat litter box in your office, huh?
Look.
During a moment.
I don't want to pressure you. But I've seen you give so much of yourself to make sure other people get what they need. And I guess I wonder if you've thought about what you need.
Oh. Oh. My goodness. Oh.
I mean, obviously, I like you a lot, Alex. You mean the fucking world to me.
Oh! Oh, girl, you know we go for it.
Oh. Kiss me. Kiss me. Kiss me. Kiss me.
Yes! Do it! Go! Oh, I'm getting like. Yes! Oh, she's on her toes! That's so cute! Oh, that's adorable! Oh, I'm so happy! Oh, fuck! Whoa. That is pure happiness right there, man. Yeesh. wall. Oh. I'm like, I want to cry. Or you could just stay.
You don't have to decide anything now, okay? Just
Raven,
think about it.
I will.
What are you doing?
Thank you.
Get down. Bitch, you just got litter all over my desk.
Oh. Find me later.
Excuse me. Oh! My goodness. Ah! No, she's like, fuck! What's that? No! No! Keep it. I didn't know what she was gonna do with that. I thought she was gonna chuck it.
Can I tell you something? I think I solved it. Why you died. Who's responsible. Isn't that crazy?
Oh, we know it's tight.
I'm out of threads to pull. Which is terrifying. Because on the other side of all this, after Typhon, after you, there's just normal life. I was kind of counting on you to show me how to do that. But I think I can figure it out. I just wish you were here to see it.
Get down.
Okay. Also, I kissed Dad, so that happened.
Fuck yeah, you did. Okay, girl, let's get it. What is with you cats today? I'm gonna lock you out of here. You're gonna ruin this whole video. Probably makes half the video, let's be honest. Don't chuck it. Because somebody's gonna find it. I couldn't tell what she was gonna do with that, and I'm like, oh fuck. They twisted my light. It's better. Oh, Alex.
Alex. Do you have the USB drive?
I do.
Oh, that's right.
It's all here. Gabe's call. Their secret plan. The cover-up.
You need to come with me to the station.
What?
Alex? Don't make this hard.
What? What? Why? Why do I feel like they pinned it on her somehow?
Probably isn't how you pictured your first spring festival, huh?
No shit, Sherlock.
Not exactly.
Coffee?
Really? Sure.
Coffee would be great. Thanks.
I don't know why I offered. We're actually out.
Hike.
Okay.
Why am I here?
That's my question, exactly.
The long and short of it is, Diane is charging you with stealing her USB drive.
What the hell are you talking about?
Did you steal this USB drive or not?
Why does it matter?
Please tell me you looked at it.
I can't. Sorry.
What?
You're conducting an investigation into Typhon, right? Everything you've been looking for is on that drive.
Despite my best efforts, the case is closed.
What?
The order came down today. I did what I could, but, you know, the evidence just wasn't there. Sorry, Alex.
I'm dumbfounded.
I have the evidence. Right here.
It doesn't matter.
The system is fucked.
Look. What happened to my brother wasn't an accident. It was criminal. The files on that drive prove it.
That could be true. But let's say it is.
Look at it.
The issue is, you stole Typhon's property. I can't work with that.
I just handed you a smoking gun. It shouldn't matter how I got it.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe not. But it does. Alex, you're not thinking about this clearly.
Seems pretty clear to me.
Yeah, no kidding.
You with computer fraud. That's a federal crime, Alex. 5 to 10, easy.
That's fucked.
You know what? Fuck Diane. This isn't justice. This is a joke.
It's not that bad.
How? Hey, what?
I talked to her, and despite how angry she is at everything you did, she's willing to let it go.
What? How? By what? Signing something?
If you agree to drop everything...
Yep!
Typhon won't press any charges.
She's only offering that deal because she knows I have her. She's guilty, Pike.
Even if you're right, your only
evidence is... What is with you, dude? Taking giant-ass dumps. Oh, my God.
I think you should...
Fuck that. I'm not signing anything.
Alex.
No. Typhon buried something in the mountains. Something so massive, they ignored Gabe's call and set off the blast just to cover it up. Don't you want to know what it is?
What do you mean, cover it up?
Another blast, unannounced, set off at the exact same time at the old mining site. And all of it happened just a few weeks before inspections were set to begin. Come on, Pike. It's all right here.
Yeah, believe it, buddy. Look into it.
Like I said, it doesn't matter.
God does.
Alex, please.
He must be being controlled by this shit too.
And we can both go back to the party.
No.
Alex, this is not an offer that you can choose.
I said no.
No is not an option.
What are you so scared of?
Yep.
See for yourself.
Uh-oh.
Shit. What could be in that envelope? A deal, just like they offered Charlotte.
Typhon Mining Security Threat Evaluation. Subject, Alex. Anti-Typhon sentiment, brother Gabe Chen died in accident-related Typhon Mining Blast. Assessment, intel shows subject has a high level of determination and efficacy. Negative affection, or affectation, has persisted beyond predicted bereavement periods. Excuse me. AGP Private Investigation Services. Threat assessment, observation dates. What the hell? Began following subject after meeting with Mac. Subject met with man, identified Ryan Lincoln. Subject spent 3 hours in apartment Wi-Fi screen monitoring. Revealed searches into Typhon's history and legal litigation records. Subject met and spoke with client. That's fucking creepy. Close friend, Gabriel. Assisting Alex with their efforts against Typhon, involved in an extremely distraught over accident. Subject has a high level knowledge of both geography and residents of Haven. What the fuck? These are fucked up. Third evaluation, close friend. Assisting Alex in her efforts is proven resourceful and dangerous. Wow. They literally are keeping records of everybody connected to her. So the thing is, if she doesn't back down, they're basically going to go after everybody else that she's close to.
Is this a threat?
Yep.
What did you expect? Huh? The Typhon, a global organization with billions in revenue, an army of lawyers, and who knows how many politicians in their pockets would just throw up their hands and say, "You got us."
I don't know. I was just focused on getting the truth.
The truth is that you have no idea what Typhon is capable of.
Yes, I don't.
Shit.
Believe me, I want nothing more than to make these fuckers pay. I've learned the hard way that it's not possible.
The scary thing is, are they spying on them right now?
Too connected, too ruthless. You can hate me if you want. Call me a coward. But I don't want to lose you like we lost Gabe.
Pike is terrified of Typhon. I bet if I took his fear away. But it's not just about me. Steph and Ryan are in danger.
There is no reason to take his fear away. There's no fucking point.
I want to hurt Typhon so bad. But can I really put their lives at risk along with mine?
Nope. Not right now. Fuck. The thing is, if it was just her life, I would do it, just because, yeah, probably some shitty things could happen, but at least she could hold herself accountable in those things, whereas if you're putting other people's lives into play, she could lose friendships based off of this, and I don't want anything to do with that, plus I don't even know what taking his fear would do. So, sign the damn floor!
Yeah. X marks the spot.
Can't turn back now. Time to sign my soul away.
It fucking sucks. I just want to read it.
Fuck me.
Agrees to drop all charges against Alex. Hereby for his release, he charges are dropped. One federal count of computer fraud. One state count of theft in exchange to release a season. This sucks. I don't want to do it. But only because I'm trying to protect other people. Like I said, if it was just her, that's different.
Thank you, Alex. You did the right thing.
You did the right thing to save your life. Not the right thing in regards to justice. And it's sad that the whole fucking town is so scared. And yet she thought this was the perfect little city. Girl. that's terrible. So what would happen if she betrayed it? Would she just get those counts again? I don't know. Guess it's hard to say. Come see me when you get the chance. Okay. Gotta go downstairs. We just came up. Oh my god, look at that laptop. All the stickers.
can't believe this. I had them. How did it go so wrong? I have no idea what to do next. Maybe talking to Jed will help me feel better.
Probably. Ah, I know, that fucking sucks. Alright.
First, I need to get out of this dress.
Yep.
It was special for me too, Steph.
Sadly, enjoy that ice cream. Festival is over, but the fun continues at Avalanche Ice Cream. I finally grew a pair and told a very special girl how special she is, and the scariest part wasn't telling her, it was realizing how dumb I was for waiting so long. Damn, I think you deserve 2 scoops for that one. That's so cute. What festival, Haven? We ate during my mom there. Okay.
I'm glad Ducky had a nice night.
Aww.
He deserves it.
Cute.
Maybe I should start charging for my services.
Oh, yeah, because she hooked them up. Oh, cute. Oh, cute.
Okay. I got it.
Yes!
This is a pretty great
thing. Oh, so it was. Aw. That's so cute. That's, like, the only reason I like small town vibes, but, yeah. Otherwise, I'm like, eh. Okay, let's see. No texts. Oh, yeah, Ducky. Oh, come on. Steph is good, he's hiding her feelings. Maybe it has something to do with the LARPing, knowing how to wear a personality like a mask. But tonight I could tell that underneath the genuine excitement was a vein of anxiety, a tiny voice whispering, you have a deal with whatever comes after. She asked me to leave with her, to see the world with her. And all at once it occurred to me that the wide open sky above us would look just a little different from some other rooftop in some other place, and for a second I ached to see it, little stages and little bars, a whole secret network of strangers waiting to be made less strange, even if... Aww. Oh, I love the pike. Ah, goodness gracious. Okay. Okay, so...
Yep. The tables seem to have turned, all right.
I still gotta look around, because I still just want to make sure I get everything I need.
Hope he's doing okay. Riley probably can't help me hack Typhon. Looks like I'm on my own now. I don't want to drag Ryan and Stefan any deeper.
Yeah, that's my fear. It's,
This isn't over, Gabe. I promise.
I know. Okay, just making sure.
I guess the night wasn't all bad.
Okay. Change on clouds. What options do we got today? Oh.
Might as well go talk to Jed now.
Hold on, I want to see what else there is.
I look better than I feel.
Haven Spring saber tooths.
Can't wait to have nightmares tonight.
Sad. Okay.
I think I'm all played out for tonight.
Oh, girl, you and him. Not playing the game. Love the music though.
Feels like the LARP was 100 years ago.
Okay. Leave the door.
Hey, Jed.
There she is. Have a seat.
I have a seat.
Something tells me you've had a more exciting spring festival than you planned for.
Oh, you could say that.
You saw Pike arrest me.
And let you go, apparently.
Give me a drink.
Then there's that business with Ryan and Steph earlier today. I wasn't sure why it took all three of you to work out Diane's lunch order.
Yeah.
I know you're used to looking out for yourself. Gabe was like that. But Haven's a community. We help each other.
Tight.
I want to help you. But first, you have to let me know what's going on.
Oh, no!
Let me guess. This is going to be a choice.
What have I got to lose?
Oh, okay. Okay.
Typhon killed Gabe. I have proof.
What proof?
I stole it from Diane. Emails and documents proving there was a second explosion the night Gabe died. To cover something up, Jed. Some secret they buried. I don't know what it is. I don't even know what to do next. But I'm not giving up. Not ever.
What's he gonna say? Say something. Anything. Say something!
I know what they're hiding.
Whoa! Whoa, wait, what? What? What is it?
Don't. Please, Jed. What's the truth? What are they afraid of?
Typhon's the devil that runs this town. I've been carrying their secrets for far too long.
Help me!
I know what they buried in the mountains.
Tell me.
Watch him get shot in the head.
I'll do one better. I'll show you.
What? But they're buried. Watch him die, though, because he's trying to reveal the secrets. Watch.
There, up ahead.
Oh, this is not going to be good. He's going to die. I can just feel it.
Middle of nowhere. About two clicks that way is the mining site where you search for Ethan. Five clicks that way is town.
What is this thing?
Ventilation shaft. They're scattered everywhere. Over the years, mines grow into mines, creating a labyrinth under Haven. What you're searching for is down below.
Why do I feel like he's also going to try to kill her?
Jed. Why are you sad?
I'm sorry, kid.
No!
Just
holy shit!
Gun down.
I tried to talk you out of it, scare you off. I was sure those pictures of Ryan and Steph would do the trick.
Wait, he did those?
But you were relentless. Won't leave damn well enough alone.
You don't have to do this.
I do. 12 years ago, I made a mistake.
What?
The kind of thing that you can't undo.
And what is that? Save somebody?
But Typhon made me a deal. A way to save my town. Give my boy a normal life.
I'm assuming he just doesn't want Ryan involved in all this stuff.
Go to hell.
What? I don't think he shot her in the head, right? Because... Okay. What? What is happening? What? Just like what? Okay. Wow, there's a lot of people who didn't sign it. Wow, okay. Okay. I like how more people went gay, yes! Nice moment at the bonfire. Didn't sit on the couch. Yes, pick Salem. 30% of people didn't meet her? What the fuck?
Oh.
Cute. Ryan didn't meet. Nope. No. My gosh. There's a lot of people who didn't. Okay. Wow, people. Yes, help that person. Yep. My God! So is this the last chapter then? Oh, fuck. Does that mean I'm gonna have to just do this whole chapter? I don't know how long it is. Oh. Wait, now where is she?
Welcome back, Alex.
Wait, did she move back?
You want to talk about your time in Colorado?
Oh, no. What?
Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
How did she get out? Sure.
I learned to let myself feel, I guess. And to not be afraid of those feelings. Couldn't one argue that those old fears turned out to be justified? What do you make of that friction? I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Got to kiss a pretty girl.
Okay, this is weird. This doesn't seem real.
But Alex, you're right back where you started.
No, it's gotta be some kind of dream. It's gotta be some dream, right?
You're wrong. I don't belong in here. If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
Yep, it's gotta be some kind of dream. All right.
What the fuck?
That's my... What the hell? I know, all those flashes, I'm like,
I guess that's me. Case number 53322.
Emotional instability, occasional violent outbursts, hallucinations, visual hallucinations. What does that say? Oral? Delusional ideation, depression, anxiety.
Thrown down a... What?
Okay, wait. There we go. Alex experiences a detailed and robust delusion that she is able to read other people's emotional states and believes that because of this ability, she is uniquely equipped to help others overcome their emotional trauma. It's difficult to overlook the irony. Someone as profoundly dysfunctional as Alex adopting the role of emotional caretaker. Had she not been returned to my care, I do not think it hyperbolic to speculate that her reckless attempts at fixing her friends and family would eventually have gotten someone hurt. It's my belief that Alex's delusions constitute a threat to her continued well-being as well as those of others. As such, I recommend Alex being thrown down an endless pit, her body shattered against each jutting board and errant brick until she is forgotten in the darkness beneath the world. This is, in my professional opinion, the most humane thing we can do for her. Okay, yeah, this is fucked up. Excuse me.
12 years ago, I made a mistake. The kind of thing that you can't undo.
Alex,
These don't belong to Dr. Lin. A tuning peg.
Yeah, oh, the guitar tuning peg. As you never know. Oh. Okay, hold on. In light of all recent excitement, now is a good time to remind Helping Hand residents that impulses to leave our institution, while understandable, are being resisted. Remember, the outside world is sharp-toothed and possessed of an insatiable hunger, and you are soft and slow and appetizing. Why throw yourself in its mouth? Throw yourself instead of mine. What the fuck?
How did I even get back here?
Attention residents, please join me in welcoming Alex Chen back to Helping Hands. We're happy and that's surprised. Alex has one more submitted herself into stultifying and insult. ISO and missing patient answers to Alex. She was always scratching at the door trying to get out and she declaws. What the fuck? This is weird. What?
Is that what I look like? Really?
That's a cute little poster.
Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock.
I don't get that. Okay. We're leaving. We're leaving! She's somewhere. Oh, fuck.
Of course.
Okay, how do I get out? How do I get out?
Not getting out that way.
Okay, not the poster, not the guitar. I don't understand! Okay.
I guess that's me.
Yes.
Case number 53322.
Should I open it again? It was the same shit. What am I missing?
Dr. Lin always records our sessions.
There's... Okay, she has the tuning peg, right? Yeah. What?
Alex Chen?
Never heard of her.
The guitar case has never heard of me.
What?
Sure. Huh.
Oh, the case number. 53322. 53322! Bye-bye. It's the only number that makes sense. This is so weird. I just want to know what the hell is happening. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh. Okay, that's okay. She's probably waking up, because that's got to be from the gunshot, or being hit in the head of falling, or something, you know. Back into reality! Oh, thank God. Not that I want her to be here, but I'm just sick of dream state. She is.
Oh.
Thank God she didn't fall all the way. She could probably get herself back up if she wanted to. Oh, there's a ladder too. Oh God. That is if the ladder's even stable. Come on! Oh, fuck. Damn it. She's gonna be stuck down there for probably this whole chapter, I'm guessing. She's gonna find her way out, though. I believe it. No! Don't tell me this. Oh, please tell me she's in the hospital. Or something. Ah! Mmm! Enough with the dreams!
Alex.
Ah! No, she's not dead. No. What the fuck?
You're dead.
I'm sorry. So,
lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
Isn't that weird to think that there's more people who are dead than alive?
I want to say...
that have existed.
A hospital?
Dr. Mendez to intensive care?
Ooh,
Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick, so is our father. But it's a different kind of sickness.
Is it mental?
Play your part.
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave.
This is so bizarre.
Alex, go check on your mother.
Weren't you just in there?
Okay.
She's not there?
She was right over there, waiting for me.
Oh, behind the curtain. I was like, what the hell? Okay, hold on. Let me go look at other stuff first. Hold on.
There it is. The painting that taught me that art sucked sometimes. We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. Gabe and I used to watch cartoons on this thing after school.
Is she in the hospital
Mom
for a long time?
Mom used to fidget with her keys whenever she was worried. It was always too hot in this room.
Why am I nervous? Does she have cancer? Whew. Got a lot of shivers. Whew.
How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleep, there's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry.
Excuse me. Ugh.
Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
What? Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Don't tell me this is gonna be like Groundhog Day and I gotta figure out the right shit.
Alex, go check on your mother.
Ah!
Okay.
She's like, huh? Whew! Man, it is cold down here. Maybe it's because I have the vent closed.
Wait. Did I miss something?
All right. Okay. Same. 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 Keys. Oh, wait.
Gabe, Alex, I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today, and I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Mom, are you okay?
Hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be different for a little while. But I am going to be okay.
Okay.
No matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry.
Well, there's something else. Oh.
We spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was full of needles. Scared me to death.
I mean, not wrong. Okay. There were a couple more things added though, right? Okay. Overnight bag, tissues, Mom. Ah, I don't know.
Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Water, Alex. Get her some water.
Don't make the woman wait! Excuse me.
Thank you. You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong? No tears, my strong girl. I want you to make me a promise. Your brother, your father, they are going to need you You have to be strong. Will you do that, Alex? Uh-huh.
She got it. Oh.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Oh, that's sad. Okay, now where are we? Creepy monitor? Whew. Okay, now where am I? I am just like, all over the place. I'm assuming that's her house in Oregon. What was it? Shushu? Is that the name of it? I can't remember.
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
Do you miss her?
Well, yeah.
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both.
This shit in the living room?
This is going to suck so bad. Play your part.
So is she just trying to fill in gaps, or what's going on? Well, no wonder she was so scarred and mentally all over the place.
There was only ever one thing to do when they got like this. Drown them out and wait for it to pass.
This song? If this is what I'm thinking it is? Yep.
Yeah. it's not so bad. It's okay, it's just me. But you know that's not how it went down, right?
Time for a do-over. Woo! Okay. Let's figure it out. Oh, the both their beds.
It was my job to keep the peace. But no matter what I did, Gabe had barely used this backpack in weeks. Nobody could get him to go to school. Mom and Dad had this TV before they had either of us. I tried so hard to keep my promise to her. Dad's laundry. I always set it here when it was done so he could find it. At least I managed to hold on to you, Shushu. Cleaning Dad's ashtray was not my favorite job in the world.
Gross. We'll go back to the other side, don't worry.
Mom's old sewing kit.
And a cookie.
Don't think I've ever even tasted a butter cookie. It was full of greeting cards. Mom kept every single one we ever got.
Lucky cat.
Thanks for trying, lucky cat. My job was to sort them in order of how close we were to a collections notice.
Oh, sad.
I can't believe they were ever this happy.
Okay, can't go upstairs.
Gabe used to steal Dad's beer all the time. It was like the one thing they didn't fight about. We never really touched these after Mom died. She was such a good cook. 2 cups water for 1 cup rice. Set timer for 30 minutes. Do your history homework. Serve. Almost empty. Almost always. I wanted to be a werewolf that Halloween. Couldn't afford the costume. I didn't even know what CPS was. Just that I was afraid of them. I didn't even know what CPS was. Just that I was afraid of them.
Okay, hold on.
Hey, Gabe. I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? That was like rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school, and my dad, like, he was helping me learn my lines.
Okay.
Must be some play. But if you need anything, my number is on there. Okay?
Water stain.
When wasn't this place falling apart? The killer mistress tabs in this book weren't even close to right. Gabe loved Son of Lead back when it was an indie. It was too gory for me.
All right. Woo!
Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine, I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job again. So we're broke again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I could,
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat.
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We can sell that.
Alex, what is it gonna take to get you to stop defending him?
If your mother could see you now.
I don't wanna hear about Mom.
Gabe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit.
Dad.
Oh.
Damn it. Alex.
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't.
Dad. Dad, it's okay. Really. I'm not hurt.
I can't do this.
Oh, yeah, so he probably mentally lost Dad? It.
Someone will come.
He just left?
Woman from CPS. Someone.
Dad.
I'm sorry.
No. No.
Well, he's taking that, you know that. Now where are we? It's like pissing me off. I'm assuming your dad was John.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Almost. But not yet. You are 12, I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, come on.
Then you're 13, 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17, you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you. You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
I don't want this.
Alex. Play your part.
I hate playing my part.
Play my part.
Okay, I'll look at the door.
Pretty sure it's locked.
Okay.
Must be after Kirk. Yeah. We weren't allowed to bring glass into the dorms. So we had to drink from this thing.
I can't.
God. They put me on so many meds.
Methamphetamine. I'm assuming, well, what is that, like Adderall? I should know this. I'm on Vyvanse. Lithium, that's for, bipolar? The other two, I'm not so sure.
Did any of them ever work?
Some of them helped. A little. None of them fixed me.
In their defense,
mutant empathy isn't exactly in the DSM.
They used to say this place wasn't a prison.
Maybe they were trying to keep you safe?
Guess so. Whatever. Oh. They should have
stood. Oh, I just keep cutting her off. Oops. Of us. Okay.
You really feel like you were their property?
We didn't belong to anyone else, did we? I took a fork in here one time and hid it under my mattress. Just cause. Fuck you.
It's kind of funny. Okay, saw the basketball.
Fancy.
Everyone had one good outfit.
That's good.
Meet the parents.
Did it help?
Nope.
Kinda think you already know the answer to that question.
Sad.
I remember the kid who put this here. Sadie? Sally. Something with an S?
You were friends at first, right?
Way at first. Then I freaked out on her and she was done with me.
I don't like
just
that
like
one.
Everyone else.
Okay, before I go to that chest, I'm just gonna make sure. Oh.
Well, there are my strings. Where's my guitar?
In the case?
I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
That's bullshit. I don't need it in the fucking rec room. I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms.
Alex, that's enough. Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
You can't do that!
How you holding up, Shu?
Can't believe how long you've had that thing.
That thing was my only friend after you left.
Sad.
I used to write one every day. Stupid.
Why? You clearly missed him.
And I thought he missed me. Hence, stupid. Sad. Guess I missed a few days.
Alright. Go to the footlocker. What's in it? These potential adopters? Oh.
She's been through so much. I just don't know if we're prepared for a troubled girl.
Sad. So she literally had to sit there and like, that's terrible.
It says here she's sensitive. What is that?
She's never found a home before.
It just sounds like a pet. I hate that.
I'm sure she's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but there's just something... broken. Wrong.
With her.
I'm sorry.
Why?
You need to see it.
see what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you. Mom died. Dad left. I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us...
You were 11 years old.
It's not your job.
You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. People leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich.
Sorry.
Make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up. No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better. Now get up.
What?
Get up and fight.
Back to reality. Ugh. I'm surprised her glasses aren't shattered, because that's my first instinct. Oh. That's scary. Oh, how convenient. A lantern. I hope she can find some secrets down here. Nice. Oh, that's from... from Gabe. I can't even fathom how bad that must hurt. Come on. I would take that mining hat and put it on my head, just in case. I hope you find the juiciest secrets down here. Take that helmet.
I've got to find a way out of here. No more ladder. Not that I'd be much good at climbing.
Oh, fun. Dead
rat. Mines growing into mines. Just like Jed said.
Sad.
I'm gonna choose not to read anything into this.
probably better.
I could almost laugh, if it wouldn't hurt so much.
Sad.
Ugh. How long has this stuff been down here?
A long, long time, girl. I'm surprised nobody's tried to come down here unless they just thought they would be spied on. Where are the juicy deets? I don't even know where to go.
No. Come on, no.
Ah, this is making me tense up.
I can do this.
This makes me nervous. Ah. What is she doing?
Okay. That's something.
Weird. Ah! I just can't stop. Fuck.
That aura is the only lead I've got.
Damn. I can't even run because she's just limping. I guess that's fine. What could be down here that's so crazy, besides, like, some prostitution barn or...
All right, boys, getting close.
Helldivers for life, huh, Jed? Dig so deep, we see where the devil sleeps.
Goddamn right.
This is it. This is what Typhon tried to bury.
A lot of runoff moisture in this soil. Jed, we gotta call it. This dig is fucked.
Nothing's fucked.
Jed, we got no pumps running. No.
My teams have never quit a dig this deep before. We finish the job. Steady goes. Steady.
Fuck was...
Move! Come on! Clear the tunnel!
Who's on radio?
Jed! Fuck! Jed! Jed!
Oh my god.
We gotta move! Now! There's still men back there! They'll drown!
Yeah, and so will we if we don't get the fuck out! Make the call, Jed!
God damn it! God damn it! Everyone, let's go! Now!
Oh, I'm just buried. Is there bodies?
Like fireworks. Must be where Typhon blew the charges.
Oh. Makes sense. God, what the hell could it be? What the hell is that? Down here.
Jed! Come back! Jed, you son of a bitch!
Jed, you gotta stop, man.
Jed! Fuck you, Jed! Come back!
So her dad drowned.
It's over, Jed. He's not coming back.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Right? Razor drinks. who had this location on December 30th pulled out.
And during my time here, I've come to realize what makes Haven so special. It's a flower shop run by multiple generations. A bar owner who greets every customer by name. It's a spring festival.
He's gonna be shook when she walks in the door.
100 years. History, loyalty, pride. These values which define Haven are the same values that Typhon was built on. And that is why our partnership has been so successful.
Where's her beanie?
It's been my privilege to renew Typhon's commitment to Haven.
Fuck.
We believe in this community, and we're tremendously excited for its future.
Alex, where are you?
Thank you, Diane. I think I speak for all of us when I say we're eager to make this official. So, time to vote, folks. And then lunch.
Yes, come on! Come on, show us, boss.
Alex, oh my god.
I'm fine.
You are not fine. We have to get you to a doctor.
What happened to you?
I don't care.
I found out something you need to hear. I'm sorry.
What?
I don't fucking care.
Alex, you're hurt. Do you need help? We can call an ambulance.
Typhon's been lying to all of you. And so has Jed Lucan.
Alex, what's going on?
You motherfucker.
Fuck you.
What the hell happened?
Oh, come on!
I was down in the mine last night. I saw what Typhon's been hiding for 12 years. Jed Lucan isn't a hero. That whole story is a lie. Jed caused the accident. And then he abandoned 7 of his men. He let them drown to save himself. There were pictures of me and Gabe down there in the dirt. Because one of those miners was my father. Typhon wanted to keep this covered up in case it jeopardized the vote.
They're afraid.
Everyone at that company is scared to death. All they do is protect themselves. So they decided to bury the evidence. And nothing was going to stop that blast. Not even the fact that there were 4 people up in the mountains. That's how Gabe was killed. Jed knew all along. He covered up the truth about the past, about Gabe. And when I found out, as you can see, he tried to kill me too.
Oh, please, people, believe it. Please. Don't think I'm crazy.
Why aren't any of you saying anything?
We don't want to embarrass you, Alex.
Huh?
I wasn't asking you.
The things you've said obligate me to at least address them.
These accusations are, well, they're insane.
Oh,
and trying to go into the mine was obviously a very dangerous, very illegal thing to do. But we all empathize with your situation.
Oh my God!
You've been through so much. Your brother was your only family, wasn't he? I can only imagine how much you want an explanation for his loss.
Or to beat you into the next decade, girl. And holy fuck.
Make your life seem less unfair.
Why don't you just tell the truth? You've been planning your exit from Typhon anyway.
What?
You never signed up for threats or attempted murder. You hate this. Now's your chance to stop.
Dad? Do you have any...
You're really gonna believe your fucking dad? If he's telling you
No. I don't. I've tried to be there for Alex since Gabe died.
No!
I don't know. I hoped I could be something of a father figure to her.
Shut up! Shut up!
All I can guess is, sometimes when we're hurting, the people we lash out at are the ones who were trying to help.
Why? No, stop.
You tried to kill me. How can you stand there and say these things?
Alex.
You're a monster.
What a dick. Oh,
please. I know this is hard to accept. You all trust him. I did too, but I'm telling the truth.
I believe you. Of course I do.
Of course you do, Steph, please. Come on.
I believe you too.
Fuck yeah. Let's go, Charlotte.
Horrified and shocked and still processing everything, but I believe you.
Thank you. Woo! Come on, Ryan. Come on. You ass. Ducky?
I would like to speak.
Okay.
This young lady came to Haven as a stranger. But over the last few weeks...
Oh, my God.
She's become one of us. Now, her story certainly seems... unlikely, if not impossible. But she deserves at least an investigation of her claims.
Yes, yes, she does.
We ought to take her seriously.
Ike! Ike!
Ducky, you're being unhelpful.
Shut the fuck up, Eleanor. No.
Alex, sweetheart.
No, you're already losing your mind. I don't want to talk to you.
Our mind can play tricks on us.
Shush!
None of it.
Not because of a sickness, dude. Get out of here.
So hard to admit you need help.
Oh!
But struggling alone. No. You shouldn't have to go through that.
My God, no. Stop it. Stop it. Ryan?
Worried about you.
Ryan!
Let us help you.
Come on, Ryan! Where's Riley when we need her? Pike?
How about you?
She's too scared!
I heard you out last night. You know the deal.
Ugh!
You're a cop. You can do something.
Alex, just give it up.
You coward.
This would have been way harder if I would have chose to romance Ryan. Thank God I did not.
believe me, right?
I don't think he does.
Ryan?
Why are you doing this?
Because it's the truth?
My dad is not a murderer.
Oh, come on!
Were you afraid we couldn't get Typhon? Is that why you need someone else to blame? I thought we were in this together. For
oh
Gabe.
Oh my god.
Ryan.
No. I'm not gonna let you do that to me anymore.
Ryan, what the hell? I know he's your dad, but look at her. Why would she lie about this?
It's going too far.
Alex almost died.
It's not true.
You're fucking denial!
Ryan, after everything? Seriously, fuck you! Stop.
Whoa, what is she doing?
I know why you tried to kill me. It's not what you tell yourself. That you thought it was best for Haven. This was never about Haven at all, was it? This was about you. I know it's easier not having to think about the men you buried. You want to look away and pretend the people you hurt aren't people. But I won't let you. My father worked for you. His name was John.
He was a screw up.
He made a lot of mistakes. He wasn't a good father. I think he came here trying to be better.
That's why Gabe came
he
here, probably.
Him.
Trying to find him.
And then Gabe, my big brother. Haven was his second chance. He was so proud of who he'd become. A great boyfriend. A cool dad. But he died. Because of you. And then there's me. For so many years, I just wanted to survive. To get through. Haven changed me. I started to think about the future. I want to belong somewhere. I want to know that there's a place and a group of people who wouldn't be the same without me. I was starting to feel that here. And you tried to murder me. You would have ended my life just so you wouldn't have to face the truth.
Ugh. That's sad. Shifty eyeballs. Admit it! Please! Please!
You've forgotten it. Haven't you? You've plastered over it with another story. You tell yourself you're a hero. A strong leader. Sometimes that means making hard choices. Decisions that could lead to people dying. Few men could handle that. Haven's lucky to have you. But that's the lie. If you scrape it away, what do we see? Mm. 11 years ago, you led a group of men to their deaths. And you couldn't even say those words out loud. Because you're a coward. You couldn't imagine saying it to your wife. Saying it in front of your son. Every day you were brave enough to go underground and look death in the eye. But you couldn't muster the courage to admit a mistake. I can feel you trying to pull away. Don't.
She's got him in the palm of her hand.
Sometimes it's so awful you think you're gonna break. But when you come out the other side, and you're whole and free and still alive, then you'll finally know how strong you really are. See the truth about you. You hate yourself. You hate what you did in the past. You hate what you've done to keep it secret. And the more you deny that hatred, the worse it grows.
I just want him to combust and admit everything.
You are. I've seen the worst parts of you.
Forgive or condemn? Forgive's powerful. Let's do that.
And I forgive you.
I like that's gonna make him crack. Because I feel like saying condemn would have just made him worse. So what does this mean for us?
And the news is still coming in on the Typhon mining scandal that has rocked the western slope town of Haven Springs, where a council meeting was the scene for shocking revelations. Local bar owner and council president Jed Lucan admitted in a tearful confession to covering up the deaths of 7 Typhon employees as their manager 12 years ago. A recent cover-up, which involved a clandestine and unpermitted explosion to thwart inspections, caused the death of Haven local Gabe Chen last month. Mr. Lucan is currently in police custody, awaiting arraignment. We will have plenty more about this development.
Thank God!
Story, including the resignation of Typhon CEO, the market impact, and what it all means for your drive time commute coming right.
Yeah. The silence is worse. I need to get some air.
Oh. Steph, does this mean you're gonna stay?
After summoning all my strength and willpower, I'm now ready to move from the bed to the rooftop. Do I need a Charlotte Harmon portrait? I kind of think I need a Charlotte Harmon portrait.
Location.
I've got some continued support for you.
Oh boy.
The phrase recent events is doing some work in this post.
Eek.
It never ends.
Since it... Ha! Yeah, no kidding. The White House. Yellow. Get out of here, Eleanor. She bugs me now. Open the bar. You ain't there no more, hotshot. Well, these are older, I'm assuming.
I'm so sorry I worried you all.
Aww.
I bet Steph wishes she could reword that. But it's pretty funny.
We don't really have a name yet. Oh! Oh no! That's bad. Come on, man. Okay, that's all old. All the text messages. Okay. Pretty sure you just lost your phone. Ryan's freaking out. Okay, we're both freaking out. So make sure you're safe, Alex. Oh, gosh. Oh, Ethan. When did you learn that the father loved Tatum Springs at Warford? Yeah, I learned. Huh. Oh, probably an interviewer. Aw. I don't ever know what to say. I left my heart break 7. Don't know if she lived like that. I remember. Aw. Dear Alex, you've been through an awful lot these past few weeks, but your resilience and courage continues to astound me. I have no doubt that you will weather this affront against your person with the same grace as you demonstrated to me during our lovely dance at the Spring Festival. A moment I will never forget, so please, or I will not soon forget. So please remember that we're here for you. He's funny. Oh, fuck. Hey, Chen, didn't think you'd actually take down Typhon. You're braver than I ever imagined. Now you owe me a new job. No. Fuck you. Oh, fuck. Alex, I'm sorry. My dad was a hero. That's what everybody said for years, and it took so many lies and hold up discussing terrible lies. Typhon lied. Dad lied. The worst of all, I lied to myself. Even when the truth is right in front of my eyes, I believed him over you. I'm so sorry, and I hope one day you'll forgive me. Oh, that's nice, at least. Alex, you're incredible. No matter what, call me in a minute if you need anything. Oh. Oh! Jessica! you're coming from where? Please contact this number if you change. Oh. Okay. Can I change clothes? No. It's off the table now. Just want to see if there's anything else. Postcards. Oh, there's a bomber jacket thing.
Must be rare that a local paper gets to break out the really big headline. See? This is why I try to only read the art sections.
Okay, we got something.
You ever swing a pick before, Mr.
Chen, John, and
that's her dad's jacket.
But I'm a hard worker, and I learn fast, and I don't mind long hours.
You don't have somebody waiting on you at home?
No, sir.
No.
Well, John, guess you're a hell diver now.
Ugh.
Nothing like being called delusional by someone you trusted. I'm glad he held on to it.
Alex, they told me to destroy this jacket after the accident. I couldn't do it. Perhaps some part of me knew that I would one day need to pass it along. When Gabe first stepped into my bar looking for his father, yep, I swore I would one day return the jacket to him. Then I swore I would return it to both of you. I think you know by now what my word is worth. I did not deserve your forgiveness, but it moved me more than I knew was possible, I hope. This gift will provide you some small comfort to you in the days ahead. Damn. Okay, shrine. Light interview.
I am now a double victim. First, to Jed Lucan's horrible deception, and now to Typhon's attempts to scapegoat me for their crimes. But I will fight, tooth and nail, to ensure that the real story is told and my name is cleared. Thank you.
Sounds like Diane is angling for a book deal.
Fuck her.
Hopefully it ends up in the fiction section.
I ain't about
where it.
It
belongs.
Okay.
They say I was powered by adrenaline that whole morning. Now I'm mostly powered by extra strength Advil. Please.
Well, would we get a song? Or da fish?
I've been playing a lot the last 2 days, trying to think things through. But I realize it's actually the opposite. When I'm playing is the only time I get to not think about Jed or Gabe or Haven and wanting to move on from the pain, but not knowing how. Most of all, what I don't think about is me, because I've never been good at that. And suddenly, it's the only question that's left. So, I just keep playing.
Okay. We'll keep going, as much as I just want to chill.
Maybe Dad deserved everything he got, but I'm still glad we were there with him in his last moments.
Ugh. Alright, upstairs. Oh. Who's at the door? Who is at the door?
Ugh. Hey, Steph. Alex,
wait. Before you say anything, I have to get this out.
What?
Okay.
What you did at the council meeting, it was the bravest thing I've ever seen. And it made me want to be brave too. So, here it goes. I want to be with you. I don't give a shit about playing music or seeing the world.
What?
I mean, I do, but only if it's with you. And if you'd rather stay here instead, then... fuck it. I want to stay here too.
Yes. That was amazing.
I've never had anyone barge in to tell me that they wanted to be with me before.
Yeah? How'd it feel?
Oh.
You've, given me a lot to think about.
Girl, you don't just...
You're good. That was the idea. You know where to find me.
Girl, you just say, nope, let's go to my room.
Thanks, Steph.
Ah! Fuck. Oh, God. Woohoo! I'm here for it. Ah. I'm like all giddy now. Oh, so cute. Let me guess, Ryan's gonna make his way up here too. We gotta get his fucking apology.
Just tell me.
What?
My future. What to do? The night of the Spring Fest, Steph made a strong push for leaving with her. Playing on the road, the excitement of the unknown. Of course, that was before all the shit went down. Come on, you're the know-it-all. So tell me.
Actually, I do know what you should do. You should stay in Haven.
Yeah, you should.
A Of course. You're right. I've never had a home before. Friends.
I love this. A place to live. Great.
Why would I give that up now?
Then again, maybe leaving would be better.
What?
You're young, you suddenly have a little money, friends. And don't you think it's time to give this music thing a real shot? No, you should definitely leave.
Oh, fuck off. Stop it, Gabe. I don't need the mysterious spirit bullshit right now. I just need my big brother.
I'm sorry.
I know.
But here's something.
Yes?
It's 3 hours from now. A bus pulls away. You're not on it. And neither is Steph. Life goes on. You get a job working with Steph at the record store.
Oh, this is so cute! Oh my goodness.
All those years of being a music snob finally pay off.
What the fuck? Oh my god, I love this.
And little by little, time does its thing. The apartment starts to feel less like a museum and more like a home. Aww. Thoughts of Jed, of Typhon, even of me, begin to fade into the background.
Talking to somebody else. I got some D&D going.
Your stage. You perform every week to a small but adoring group of fans.
Steph.
Maybe while you play, you wonder what could have been. Performing for more people in more cities, sharing your music with the world. Or maybe you never think about that much at all. You don't know exactly when it happens, but one day you look around and find that you have transformed this place just as much as it has transformed you.
Oh.
And the most extraordinary thing of all is just how normal it feels. You don't question it, you don't doubt it. I wonder what might have been. It's your life. the life you fought so hard to have. And for the first time in a long time, you just live.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
You really think I'll transform Haven?
Of course. You already have. With your gift, your music, just by being you. But Alex, that doesn't mean you have to stay. You have the potential to do that anywhere you go.
Oh, come on.
Do what exactly? Become an actual musician?
Live in a van? Travel between dingy bars, hawking your SoundCloud, pouring your soul to strangers? Sounds pretty great if you ask me. The truth is, there's no telling what that version of your future might be. The only promise is the adventure. So, what do you think?
Wow, this is a big choice. I mean, you know, it's kind of interesting because I can relate this to my own life where I thought seeking adventure would be prime. I wanted to play music everywhere. I wanted to meet new people. I wanted fans. And after the contest I won when I was 18, I thought that's where my life was going to go. And because I felt such a detachment from people who genuinely were close to me, I thought I would be getting what I wanted from being elsewhere. And the older I get, the more I don't want that. And I want stability, comfortability. I want to be around the people who I'm closest to, because if I try to seek adventure, I could be with a few close people, but I'm not near everybody who's near and dear to me and family and all that stuff. And I feel by seeking adventure, you don't ever really have a genuine opportunity to really look inward and work on yourself personally, because you're so invested in doing technically your job and expressing it out to the world, and that's all people see is how much you put into your work. And it's like, I don't want to feel like that my job is my life. I want to be able to have a balance between my job, my family, my relationship, all of that. And over time, I've just seen seeking adventure as more exhausting. And it's, you know, it is what it is, and I think people could tell me otherwise. Sway me to the other side, but honestly, I would prefer to stay in Haven. Long answer. I was to say the long. Thank you. And the thing is, it's like, if you really want adventure, like, you don't have to make it your life. You can take trips and stuff if you really want to seek that. But I wouldn't want super widespread attention to lose my privacy and all that, so yeah. I would very much rather stay home. And that's that. Okay, I was actually, I feel like, expecting the wrong people to be behind this. I didn't really think of Jed. I think I accused Ryan. Did I accuse Jed? I don't know. I don't remember. Like, this is definitely a real feel-good game because it's just, I love that emotional connection. It's just, it's very different from other games. It's not just like a big old adventure or whatever. You know, it's just, it's heartfelt and it's wholesome. I really did enjoy this. I'm glad I finished the rest of it now, because I don't think I could have split that into two. I would have been way too gung-ho about what the hell is gonna happen after. Nope. Okie dokie. Oh, wow. Okay. It was pretty split, but yeah, I would assume that there would be a bitter chunk, but I would think that forgiving would be the majority. None of the council members backed up Alex. Holy fuck. What did they do to fuck that up? That's kind of funny. Yeah, I didn't see Ryan after the vote. Wait, whoa, oh, that probably, okay, so if I would have swooned Ryan more than Steph, he probably would have stood by me, but he didn't. Interesting, Charlotte believed Alex but couldn't help. Eleanor offered to get Alex help. How did you side with Eleanor? Probably, if you wouldn't have told Riley about her sickness, she probably would have sided with you. As for Pike, I don't know how. Ducky did side with me. Yeah, that kind of bugged me. Yes, we did not get together. Wait, Steph and Alex leave Haven together, Steph. Alex don't get together. That's unfortunate. oh, man. Cute. Man, that's it. Oh my gosh. Oh god, you can go to the arcade. Oh, I know there's a, let me see. Oh, look at all those outfits, cute. Wow. Well, wait, whoa, wait. Do I have hers? Yes, I have. Did you choose to save Arcadia Bay? Well, okay, I've played it multiple times. But I think I did more so because screw Chloe. Oh, I did buy the plus. Okay, you know what? No, we're not doing that right now. We're not doing that right now, okay? This is gonna be the next part that I play. We're gonna play her part, okay? We're not gonna do it now. But anyway, I hope you all enjoyed this video. We're gonna get back to this in the next one. So, I will see you in the next video.